Well, after contracting COVID-19, First Lady Melania Trump recently canceled public engagements, citing a persistent cough. It's a common symptom of the virus, with many patients experiencing lingering effects. And this week is National Respiratory Health Week. And here to talk about the impact of the virus on respiratory health is Dr. Samuel Pope, Medical Director of the Medical ICU at Hartford Hospital. Doctor, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here. So what is happening in the body when COVID-19 strikes the lungs?
Yeah, unlike a lot of other respiratory viruses, this virus in particular is very prone to cause pneumonia. So it will descend much lower than other respiratory viruses and is attacks the alveoli, the small air sacs, directly. It's very different than a lot of other viruses we see and how prone it is to do this.
What types of symptoms do people typically have?
The first symptoms people have are often flu-like, so muscle aches, fever, and then if they're prone or they're the person that it decides to infect more fully, they'll get more shortness of breath and cough, headache. You know, there's lots of symptoms they could develop as the disease progresses.
What do we know about the long-term implications of COVID on the lungs?
Only learning now. So this is where we are. So we've certainly started to see people who have lingering effects like Melania Trump with the cough, ranging up to some pulmonary fibrosis and what looks like some long-term damage done to the lungs at the microscopic or even macroscopic level.
All right. Let's talk about the treatments available at Hartford Healthcare, your COVID recovery center.
So we're hoping, we started to see people 6-8 weeks ago who had recovered back in our first peak in April, May, who just were not feeling well. So fatigue is certainly a very common complaint for people who have had a very sick and significant course with COVID. But we also had people with headache, with shortness of breath, with, just muscle aches, joint aches, just energy levels just completely shot. So they felt like they had to sleep 4 or 5 hours after they, did even the slightest bit of activity. And so what we're hoping to do is to try to take these varied symptoms and then the ways that we know the virus can affect the body both directly and then the cytokine effects that it creates in its wake, and then plug those people in with more specific treatments, bringing to bear the leverage of our healthcare system and all of our resources.
All right, doctor, in 30 seconds left, what are preventative measures a person can take to avoid respiratory problems with COVID?
I mean, the best thing you can do is not catch it. So I think that we all know, use your mask, wash your hands, stay away from people. There's limited evidence. I know everybody with Trump got interested in zinc and vitamin D. There's limited evidence that if you are deficient in those things, that bringing them up to a normal level may help with your course of illness being less severe. But beyond that, prevention is going to be your best medicine.
All right, Dr. Samuel Pope with Hartford Hospital, thank you so much for being with us. We appreciate your time and your insight on these lung issues.